It was a super snowy night. Like, there was a blizzard that night. Hi, welcome to Angela's Anything Show. And today, I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know about buying concert tickets online. That's right, folks. As I've mentioned on this channel before, I'm a huge live music lover and I've been going to concerts since I was like 13 years old, and I've been buying concert tickets for just as long. But in the last few years, I've noticed among my friends, there's a lot of confusion about tickets that are on sale or tickets that are sold out and where to get each one and when to get each one and what website to go to. So I have to share this info with you because I cannot stand the thought of people paying more money than they should for live music. The first thing I want to tell you is the difference between primary and secondary. Primary tickets are basically the actual original box office where you get your tickets. Whether that's the box office of the actual venue or if you go to the band's like official website, get it through there. Usually the most common place where you're gonna find primary tickets is like a Ticketmaster or a Live Nation, same thing. Ticketfly, places like that. The other part is secondary tickets. So secondary tickets is just anytime you buy a ticket not from the primary source. So you'll probably know StubHub, Vivid Seats, SeatGeek. Ticketmaster has their own like resale secondary site. Don't get me started on Ticketmaster. Hashtag creating a monopoly in the ticket industry. Sorry, I have something in my eye. So again, secondary just means you're getting it from a secondary source. So let me walk you through a few scenarios. First scenario, a band you love has announced a tour, tickets are going on sale, and you want to get tickets as soon as they go on sale because you don't want them to sell out. Do not just Google like fish tickets. Millions of websites are gonna pop up saying they have fish tickets. The smartest thing to do is to go to the fish official website. Ooh, my lighting's back. Find where they are linking you to buy tickets. That is the primary source. 9 times out of 10, it'll be Ticketmaster. Whatever, it won't always be like that. Once you go there, it'll tell you exactly when the tickets are going on sale, when pre-sales are happening, all that stuff. And the price you see there is the original price. That is the price that you should be paying, okay? If the event is not sold out. Why the hell would you want to pay more money on the same seats when the event is not sold out? Now, a lot of the time, if the event is big or the artist is big, tickets will sell out really quickly. Everyone's been stuck in that Ticketmaster waiting room, you know? So what do you do when you wanna go see whatever, Fish for their Halloween run and it's sold out? This is when the secondary market is a beautiful thing because it allows you to really never miss out on anything that's sold out. So in this case, you could Google Fish tickets and you could look and see what Google returns is like all the top ticket sites. Based off my experience and knowledge, I will tell you the best secondary ticket site is SeatGeek. SeatGeek has a buyer guarantee, which means that even on the rare off chance that your ticket is fraudulent, which by the way, that does not happen a lot because sellers have no incentive to sell you fake tickets because they don't make any money. SeatGeek will reimburse your ticket. Like if your ticket is fraudulent for some weird reason, you can call them right then. They'll get you into the event. You're guaranteed. SeatGeek's website and their app are far superior to any other ticketing app or website I've used. Super fast, they have these awesome maps that are like very interactive. A lot of the time you can actually click and see like what the view is from your seat. And you can also sell tickets on SeatGeek and they don't charge you a fee, which like every other seller charges you a fee. Other secondary sites, obviously we know about StubHub. There's Vivid Seats, Cash or Trade is a great one if you're going to a lot of hippie jam band stuff. You know, you've seen them all, ticket something. Just a quick little tip on buying tickets from scalpers and stuff. Don't ever buy tickets from somebody who doesn't look like they're going to the show. There's a difference between buying tickets from somebody who's like, hey, I have extras, my friend couldn't go, blah, blah, blah. Like that's totally normal. But when you're going to a show and you see like guys just like in black hoodies that are just like on the street, this happens a lot in New York City. And they're like, I got a ticket. Like, no, don't buy it from them because you'll get ripped off and then you can't get your money back. So that's why I think it's always better to get it from a website or an app that is like reputable because they have your back, you know? The third most common scenario when you'd be buying tickets. The tickets have been on sale for a while. You don't know if they're sold out and you're just looking to buy some. Say the on sale was months ago and you're like, hey, I want to go to that show. You would think, I'm just gonna Google it. No. Still, always go to the band's official website or their Facebook page or wherever. If the show is sold out, then great. You know, you can go onto SeatGeek or wherever and then buy your tickets there. If it's not sold out, but they've been on sale for a while, that is when you can use a secondary market to kind of price shop and comparison shop. Maybe the show isn't selling that well and you can find really good seats for cheap. Plus, if you utilize like promo codes that a lot of these secondary sites offer, you could pay less than face value. So it's great to have secondary sites as an option when it's like a less coveted live event, especially if the event is getting really close and it's still not sold out. If you go onto any secondary site, it's gonna be filled with people trying to get rid of their tickets, and they'll be marking them down to probably under face value at that point. One time I went to a show that was sold out, we got all of our tickets, blah, blah, blah. And then it was a super snowy night, like there was a blizzard that night, and ticket prices on SeatGeek dropped to like way below face value, to like 20 bucks. So that is another time that you can really utilize a secondary market to get good deals. Whew! So in summation, always check the primary market first to make sure the tickets are not sold out. If they are sold out, then you turn to the secondary market, but make sure if you're using a website specifically like SeatGeek that you've checked, because there's oftentimes promo codes or discounts for people that first sign up or use the app. So make sure you're getting all of that goodness. And third, if the event isn't sold out, but it's been on sale for a while, use secondary websites to price shop and compare them to primary ticket prices, because you might just get an awesome deal. And finally, if an event is sold out, super expensive on the secondary market, but you really wanna go, keep checking that event, and depending on day of week, time of day, the weather, that ticket price could drop substantially before the show. I hope that makes sense. I hope that was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions at all in the comments below, and I will see you next time. See you later, fuckers. Love ya. Bye. Oh, yeah. And thanks for watching. And the Landing Show. Bye.